Since the 1970s, U.S. foreign policy has used more honey than vinegar in its dealings with Beijing. China's definitely changed as a result, but not exactly the way Washington wanted it to.
You know, the world was much different then. We imagined engagement with China would produce a future with bright promise of comity and cooperation. But today we're all still wearing masks and watching the pandemic's body count rise because the CCP failed in its promises to the world. If we want to have a free 21st century and not the Chinese century of which Xi Jinping dreams, the old paradigm of blind engagement with China simply won't get it done.
Pompeo's speech seems to have a lot in common with that of Winston Churchill's when he declared an iron curtain had descended across Europe, dividing it into Soviet and Western spheres. It was the beginning of the Cold War, and with Pompeo's us against them rhetoric, another Cold War between the U.S. and China may be brewing.
Now, this isn't about containment. Don't buy that. It's about a complex new challenge that we've never faced before. The USSR was closed off from the free world. Communist China is already within our borders.
Washington's hostile stance is no doubt part of a recent pitfall in Sino-U.S. relations. Huawei's ban in the U.S., accusations of tech theft, disputes in the South China Sea. It's all reminding experts of a warning former President Richard Nixon made decades ago.
We must cultivate China during the next few decades while it is learning to develop its national strength and potential. Otherwise, we will one day be confronted with the most formidable enemy that has ever existed in the history of the world.
Unfortunately for Washington, Nixon was right. When he was president, China was still an economically backwards country with its eyes on rapid development. Fast forward to the present, and the Communist Party's accomplished much of what it set out to do. It's lifted millions out of abject poverty. It led the country to what looks like a quick recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic. And it doesn't seem willing to stop in the face of Washington's statements.
Pompeo's remarks, which ignore facts and are full of ideological bias and Cold War mentality, are a hodgepodge of political lies intensively made recently by senior U.S. officials.
Accusations of human rights abuses, authoritarian name-calling. Pompeo's even labeled China's system a new tyranny. It does all sound a bit crusade-y, but then again, it's nothing new in America's foreign policy playbook.
The troika of tyranny in this hemisphere, Cuba, Venezuela, and Nicaragua, has finally met its match. Oppressive regimes and ideologies, forces of oppression, totalitarianism, and domination.
Well, despite the Trump administration's best efforts, the so-called troika of tyranny is still around. Even where U.S.-backed regime change was successful, it's still no walk in the park. In Iraq, the government is basically powerless to combat militias that see it as a U.S. puppet. And in countries where the U.S. failed, like Venezuela, it's a huge waste of taxpayer money. China, though, is a lot more powerful, and with U.S. allies unwilling to get behind this new strategy, Pompeo might need to rethink his approach.
The so-called Cold War has already started. And actually, in my opinion, the so-called Cold War between China and America has never stopped in the past 3 decades, because the United States has never stopped in the way of thinking of Cold War, that when they are talking, thinking about China. The whole world is very clear which country, which administration is more tyranny in the world affairs especially. So this is the key question that for many people to understand. I think this is the United States, they have really tyranny that and the ruling in interference in the other countries' domestic affairs.